Roger Weiland, Chris Honorato at the Berkshire Bank Pavilion. Opening day in Saratoga. Gates open till at 11. Post time is at 1 o'clock. John Preachy returns as our WNYT racing analyst, also our racing analyst right here on Big Board Sports on 104.5 The Team. Good morning, John Preachy.
Good morning, Roger. I never really expected to have a rough trip 1 hour before post time.
Well, here you
a little bit more luck than I had this morning.
I hear you. Well, listen, not only do we want to say it's great to have you back and so many years together, but we also want to launch a brand new partner for you on this program that's going to be with you and partnering with you and with us on 104.5 The Team ESPN Radio, and I'll let you take it from there.
Well, that would be ExpressBet you're talking about, Roger. And as a result, something new has been added this year. We've never done this in 30 years together. But they've given me $100 every day. And I'm going to tell our audience, hopefully, how to spend it correctly on that day's feature race. So when we get to that portion of the program, the bankroll play, indeed, would be made possible by our friends at ExpressBet.
So we welcome them as a major partner to Big Board Sports throughout the meet as they partner up with the John Preachy segment here on Big Board Sports on 104.5 The Team ESPN Radio. John, let me just throw a generic thing out that you sit here today and you watch all the people coming in. This never gets old, partner. It never gets old.
I can't wait. Listen, man, I'm 1,500 miles away, and I can feel the excitement here. I mean, I'm not kidding about that. I mean, this will be my 47th year coming up to Saratoga. It's only the third opening day I've missed, but I'm going to be prime time with you guys. We'll be there for the Whitney, and we're going to stay through the Travers. Heard you talking about the Travers. It's going to be a beauty.
Yeah, and it could feature the three Triple Crown winners. What do you like on today's card, John?
Okay, well, we've got two features, as you mentioned, when you were talking with Paul a little earlier. The Schuylerville, well, there are 9 fillies in there. They're coming from 5 different states and our friends from north of the border. But we took the Lake George because, you know, turf racing, for the most part, is really popular with our bettors these days. And besides, we've had, it's a larger field. As might happen, but again, we'll need a good trip, and the good trip we're hoping it'll look to get is for a filly named Dream Dancing. This is a Mark Cassey trainee. I've loved her since Florida this winter. She was 2-for-2 down here at Gulfstream. She was really tremendous, both physically, visually impressive. Her numbers were good too. And then came a series of things. She was very, very wide behind her stablemate, Lock Coronel. That's a filly in her own barn that Cassie thought enough of to bring to Ascot this June. So she suffered a wide trip, was beaten less than 4 lengths in there. She came back against Lock Coronel again, decided to save ground this time, and never found a hole, Roger. She was completely swamped the whole way. Didn't get out until it was much too late. Roared home. He's going to catch her in another jumps, but they don't write the race for a mile and a 16th and a couple of jumps. And then after that last time, Chad Brown had the favorite loose on a very soft lead, and Dream Dancing was forced to chase her. Either chase her or you have no chance. But that's not her best game. Today, yeah, from post 11, I think Julian Leperoux is going to wrangle her back in a big field. There should be some pace coming from somewhere. Generally, at the beginning of the meet, the turf course does favor horses, because it's a fresh course, does favor horses that come from behind. She worked a bullet with her stablemate recently. It was the best of 69 of her peers that week. That was the week of July 14th. So we're looking for Dream Dancing to get it done in the Lake George. We want a minimum of 4-1. And how are we going to make our ExpressBet bankroll play? We're going to do it thusly. First, we're going to make a straight play. We're going to bet 30 win and 30 show on Dream Dancing. Hopefully, again, getting 4-1. and then to optimize and also to use as a place saver, we're going to make two $10 Exacta key boxes. We're going to use Dream Dancing first and second with Defiant Honor, who's 10-1 on the morning line. That's a J.J. Toner trainee. Johnny Velasquez rides, the leading rider in Saratoga history. And we're also going to use Party Boat. She's a 6-1 chance. She's trained by Graham Motion, training very well at a Fair Hill base. She was a good second in the 10 Oaks last time. And now she's going to stretch out to a mile and a 16th. She's had three runs at a mile and a 16th, and she won two of those. So she gets her best distance today. So one more time. 30 to win and 30 to show on our bankroll play, Dream Dancing, in today's Grade 3 Lake George, and two $10 Exacta key boxes, Dream Dancing with Defiant Honor and Party Boat.
Hey, John, I didn't have a chance to ask Paul this, but I've wondered it here on this show for a little while. When we caught up with Todd and Chad during the week, Todd says Chad Brown's the favorite to win the training title. He did win it last year, of course. Chad says, well, you have to respect Todd because of his history and ability to win the training title here at Saratoga. You've been around this game for a long time. Are there rivalries that exist between trainers?
Oh, yeah, there are definitely rivalries that exist between trainers. And as Chad was saying the other day, in relation to Todd, you know, he has a tremendous respect for him. I think it was Mark Cathy who said it, that he has a tremendous respect for Chad Brown. He said, and it's because of that respect that you want to go out there and beat them. And, you know, and these are trainers' children, these horses. And they're very proud of their children. And they want nothing but the best from them. And they want to show up on the best days. So you know that there are big-time rivalries, and I don't think it gets any bigger than Saratoga, Todd versus Chad, and I agree with Todd. I think Chad, even though he's the leading trainer at Belmont, I think he's going to be the leading trainee here too, but aside from those two names that everybody knows, there are a couple of other names that horse players know, and I'll give these two guys out as trainers to watch this year. And that would be Brian Lynch, who's having a career year. He's winning at 21%. His horses have been getting better. They've been running good all year. He's been winning races all over the place, including Canada. And Brad Cox, a newcomer, a guy from the Midwest who has suddenly branched out this year. He's got divisions all over the place. He's done very well in New York. And I think in his first full year up here, he'll be looking to make a statement. So we've got Brian Lynch and Brad Cox as two trainers to watch at this meet, Chris.
Cool. John Preachy, it's always a pleasure, man, having you on and a new partner for your segment here on Big Board Sports. And we get your best bet rolling, and we thank you for that. We hope that all of those listening can cash in a little bit later on today in the running of the Lake George Stakes. Thank you, John Preachy. We appreciate it.
Have a great opening day, guys.